praise to you, Father. You've shown me your love, love that has raised me from dead to life, filling my heart with the Spirit of Christ to be your child once more. Yes, I shall arise and return to my Father. I will say, I have sinned, I have sinned.
This Mass is offered for all the intentions which are taken from the box. Thank you. from the box. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear sisters and brothers, today we commemorate all the faithful departed. And we pray in a very special way, we remember them with faith, hope, and trust in the promise of eternal life. Remember yesterday, we celebrated All Saints Day, and we remember all the saints. Today we are remembering the people whom we know, though they are not there with us. So during this Eucharistic celebration, my dear brothers and sisters, I want you to join me in praying for all our departed brothers and sisters, from each one of our families, our near and dear ones, our relatives, friends, well-wishers, last but not the least, we remember in a very special way all those who have died during this lockdown, right from the middle of March till date. Unfortunately, we could not attend their funerals. We could not see their mortal bodies as well. We pray for all these people's souls in a very special way and ask God to bless their souls and give them eternal peace in God's kingdom. To prepare ourselves for this celebration in a worthy manner, let us pause for a moment. Jesus tells us in the gospel, I am the life and the resurrection. If you believe in me, you will have eternal life. We ask forgiveness from God for those many moments. We have failed to understand the Christian resurrection and the resurrection of our Lord Jesus. And for this, sincerely and honestly, we acknowledge our sinfulness and say together, I confess to Almighty God, and you, my brothers and sisters, that I have grievously sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us of our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Listen kindly to our prayers, O Lord. And as our faith in your Son, raised from the dead, is deepened, so may our hope of resurrection for our departed servants, your departed servants also, find new strength. Through our Lord Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the prophet Isaiah. On that day, on this mountain, the Lord of hosts will make for all peoples a feast of rich food. And he will swallow up on this mountain the covering that is cast over all peoples, the veil that is spread over all nations. He will swallow up death forever, and the Lord God will wipe away tears from all faces and the reproach of his people. He will take away from all the earth, for the Lord has spoken. It will be said on that day, "Behold, this is our God. We have waited for him that he might save us. This is the Lord, we have waited for him. Let us be glad and rejoice in his salvation." The word of God.
Thanks be to God.
For our responsorial psalm, we shall sing the hymn, "The Lord is my shepherd."
A reading from the letter of Saint Paul to the Romans. Brethren, hope does not put us to shame, because God's love has been poured into our hearts through the Holy Spirit who has been given to us. For while we were still weak, at the right time, Christ died for the ungodly. For one will scarcely die for a righteous person, though perhaps for a good person, one would dare even to die. But God shows his love for us in that while we were still sinners, Christ died for us. Since therefore we have now been justified by his blood, much more shall we be saved by him from the wrath of God. For if while we were enemies, we were reconciled to God by the death of his Son. much more, now that we are reconciled, shall we be saved by his life. More than that, we also rejoice in God through our Lord Jesus Christ, through whom we have now received reconciliation. The word of God.
Thanks be to God.
Let us all stand as we prepare our hearts for the gospel.
Sing alleluia to the
Sing
Lord. To the Lord.
Sing alleluia to the Lord.
Sing alleluia to the
Sing
Lord.
Alleluia.
Sing alleluia.
Sing alleluia.
Sing alleluia to the Lord.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory be to you, O Lord.
When Jesus came to Bethany, he found that Lazarus had been there already in the tomb for 4 days. Bethany was near Jerusalem, about 2 miles off. And many of the Jews had come to Martha and Mary to console them concerning their brother. So when Martha heard that Jesus was coming, she went and met him. But Mary remained seated in the house. Martha said to Jesus, "Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died. But even now, I know that whatever you ask from God, God will give you." Jesus said to her, "Your brother will rise again." Martha said to him, "I know that he will rise again in the resurrection on the last day." Jesus said to her, "I am the life and the resurrection. Whoever believes in me, though he die, yet shall he live. And everyone who lives and believes in me shall never die." "Do you believe this?" She said to him, "Yes, Lord. I believe that you are the Christ, the Son of God, who is coming into this world." The Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear sisters and brothers, as we are commemorating all the faithful departed today, popularly known as we are celebrating All Souls Day. And today, my dear brothers and sisters, is a very, very special day for us, for Christians, to renew our faith in God, where God invites each one of us to confirm our faith that Jesus, our Lord and Savior, has been resurrected from life. And you and I, my dear brothers and sisters, will certainly be resurrected. It is said that life is journey and death is the end of this journey. अपना जिंदगी एक सफर है और ये सफर का अंत मयत यानी मृत्यु से होता है, ऐसा कहा जाता है. But my dear brothers and sisters, a Christian philosophy tells us that death is not the end of life. For Christian or for a believer, for the faithful person, life is not ended with the death, but it is the new beginning, because it's a journey towards our Heavenly Father. And therefore, in the Gospel of today, my dear brothers and sisters, we hear that when Jesus visits his friend's house, Lazarus, who was dead, his other friends, Lazarus' friends, must have thought, oh, Jesus has come, he missed the bus, now Lazarus is gone forever. And therefore, Martha rushed to Jesus and she said, Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died. But now whatever you ask from God, he will do it for you. And Jesus said, as we all heard in the gospel, do you believe in the resurrection? Then she said, yes, I do believe that Jesus will raise him up, God will raise him up on the last day. And Jesus said, I am the resurrection and the life. Whoever believes in me, even he or she, that person, is dead and gone in the sight of the human being. He or she will certainly live or experience eternal life in heaven because of his or her faith. Yes, my dear brothers and sisters, Jesus invites you and me to have faith in him. You and I, when we have a faith in Jesus as Christ, the living Son of God, certainly we are given the eternal life with Jesus in heaven. Today, as we are remembering all our departed faithful, our departed brothers and sisters who have gone before us, we ask God, we pray for them in a very special way. Ask God to bless their souls, grant them eternal life in heaven, where God himself has prepared a special banquet for these people along with all his saints and angels, where they may really enjoy the company of the saints and angels. We also ask God to promote and strengthen our faith in Jesus our Lord, who gives us the eternal life, who promises us about the eternal life with God our Father in heaven. We pause for a moment and pray for all those who have died and gone, particularly the people during this pandemic whose funeral we could not attend. We pray for all these people in a very special way at this moment. Let us now proceed with the offertory procession. My dear sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy church.
Look favorably on our offerings, O Lord, so that your departed servants may be taken up into glory with your Son, in whose great mystery of love we are all united, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks, Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In Him, the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for you are faithful, O Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the host and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Full of your glory.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, then Jesus took the bread and giving thanks, he broke it and gave it to the disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. And once more giving thanks, he gave it to disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of our faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that by the King of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, Oswald, our Bishop, all the clergy, let us pray in a very special way for all our departed sisters and brothers. May they rest in peace in God's kingdom. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, his spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coheirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant a peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of our Lord Jesus be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let's now offer a sign of peace to each other. Peace be with you.
Lamp of God,
Lord, you take away the sins of the world.
Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. We now make our spiritual communion with the Lord. O Lord Jesus, since I cannot now receive you in your sacramental presence, I beg you to come spiritually into my soul to enrich me with your holy grace and make me truly your own forever. O Jesus, living in Mary, come and live in me. In the spirit of your holiness, in the fullness of your power, in the communion of your mysteries, in the perfection of your ways. O divine guest, give to my soul a strong, lively faith, an unbounded trust, perfect humility, an abiding sorrow for my sins, a total abandonment to your divine will, and a perfect loving union with you in mind and heart. O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine. Lord Jesus, thank you for the blessings and graces you have given me through the spiritual communion.
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that you are your parish servants for whom we have celebrated this Paschal Sacrament may pass over to a dwelling place of light and peace. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
The Almighty God bless you. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit descend upon you and remain with you forever and ever.
Amen.
The Mass ended. Let's go in peace of Christ to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The community pray together.
Lord Jesus, help us, your family and Kairoli, to care for our church. Teach us to value each person as a gift of this parish. Let the warmth of your love melt all indifferences and cement us together into your body, the church. Be the cornerstone of our parish community. Bless our efforts to keep alive in us the zeal and commitment to bring to fulfillment a vibrant community of justice and love, where worship spells service. Saint Teresa of the Child Jesus, intercede for us. Amen.
We now pray for the relief from the coronavirus. Almighty and merciful God, who show your love to all creation everywhere, hear graciously the prayers we make for all those affected by the coronavirus in various parts of the world. We come before you asking for a quick control of the outbreak, for a healing of those affected, for the victims and their families. We pray for the doctors doing research that an effective vaccine to combat the sickness is speedily found. We pray for the government and health authorities that they take appropriate steps for the good of the people. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen.
When the sun has set and the night is gone, when the darkness falls and the light is gone, you'll be
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.